Happy holidays, everyone. Welcome to the 2022 DGF 2099 Productions Christmas Special. I'm David G. Firestone, the host, writer, creator, director, editor, and star of DGF 2099 Productions. I hope you've all had a great 2022. I've had some ups and downs. I've had some fun times this year, but I also caught COVID in September. This is a new special format we're going to be doing so that I don't have to butcher it for the copyright gods. Now, as always, I'm going to be using Winter Fireplace and iPhone Fireplace app, link in the description. And the premise here is very simple. We're going to snack some snacks, game some games, and watch some silent Christmas movies. So I'm going to need a boost to start this, so let's get started with an energy. So with the first of four sampling videos we're going to be doing during our Christmas special, we're going to go to Rockstar. I could always use a little bit of a boost at the beginning of Christmas celebrations. So today we're going to be trying Rockstar Boom Whipped Strawberry. It's got a decent strawberry scent to it. Got a good like whipped cream and strawberry taste with, but it's had a really weird aftertaste. Now see, I didn't get it that time, the aftertaste. But this is sort of a weird combination. So this is one of these things where there's nothing really wrong with it, nothing really right with it. It is what it is. It's getting a C. Could be better, could be worse. Now, with that out of the way, let's get back to the Christmas special. Now we get to the first of four silent movies we'll be watching. This is also the oldest Christmas movie I've been able to find. It's also the only movie I haven't been able to find in HD as opposed to the others that we're going to be watching. Now, released in 1904, The Christmas Angel is a silent movie directed by Georges Méliès, who is best known for the classic silent short A Trip to the Moon from 1992. The premise of this movie is that it stars an unnamed girl whose mother is ill and her father sends her out to beg. Now, if I spoil it any further, you won't want to watch it, so let's get to The Christmas Angel. So for the next thing we're going to do, this is Pinball Arcade. And I want to use this opportunity to announce right now that I'm going to be starting a new pinball channel on the first called Dave's Pinball Madness. And this will be part of the channel. The table you're seeing right now is the one that comes with the free edition of the game, Frankenstein. I'm just going to play a little bit of it now. It's not my favorite of the tables that I've got right now, but yeah, let's just get to it.
It's alive. Geneva.
Oh, no! Say my name. Who am I?
extra ball is lit. Mark is lit. Come to me. Extra ball is lit. Yes!
Elizabeth!
Say my name.
That's it! Live again!
It's alive. Lies in a shallow.
Yeah, why not? It's Christmas.
Bright the sky. It's alive. It's alive. Bright the sky.
Really?
Rebellion! It's alive.
So, since we all tend to indulge a little bit more during the holidays, with our second sampling segment, we're going to be doing Kit Kat Blueberry Muffin. I am a muffin fan, but I don't eat them all that often because I don't want to. Oh, wow. Pretty much what I would expect. It really does taste like a blueberry muffin. It's actually pretty awesome. Segments, two down, two to go. Let's get back to the special. Our second Silent Christmas short is a little girl who did not believe in Santa Claus from 1907. This short was directed by J. Cyril Dolly and Edwin S. Porter. It was released by the Edison Manufacturing Company. And it's about a young, generous boy and a poor, cynical girl, and how a belief in Santa Claus can be powerful to healing a wounded spirit. So I tried getting game footage of a game called Arcade Redemption, which is an coin game ripoff. It's not very good. The controls are too sensitive. It's not fun. It's jerky. Even the mouse sensitivity makes it unplayable. Don't waste your time. But I'm going to try a slightly better one called Game Machine Arcade Casino, which actually is somewhat better. Just load it up. And when I say it's better, I mean it's only better in comparison. I mean, when you turn it on, there's no intro scene or anything, and I'm going to be honest with you, I'm not sure the titles. I'm going to try turning the volume down. Campaign and free game, there's literally no difference between the two other than you can play all the games in free game you want. Campaign, you use one machine to unlock others. There's no real point. And I think one of the most depressing aspects of this game is you're not playing to win 5 stars or 4 stars or even 3 stars. You're playing to win 2 stars per game. What do I mean by that? Well, let's try Stacker first. And I'm actually am recording the dialogue as I'm recording game footage. So, yeah. Now, with these games, you have to wait for the entire loading screen to load. Once the intro animation is done, it makes playing that much easier. And by the way, I also like the TV in the background that shows us all the various shapes that can be made. 2 up yours and a middle finger. Okay. So right off the bat, you can't just walk up to the machine and play it. You have to make an effort to put the coin in the slot. Now, if you notice, there are coins over here. These are your lives in this game. And it really doesn't matter if you lose, because you can just play it again and you can win. So this is Stacker. Now, you're trying to stack things up. You get up to here 1 star, up there 2 stars. And we're going to have fun watching how long it takes some of these bricks to fall. I'm going to put a timer in the corner. Now, I will say that this game is kind of generous because it does give you 2 opportunities to miss. Oh, and another thing that annoys me, you have to wait for the entire game over screen. Again, just the lag here is kind of amazing. It's interesting that every other of the animations seem to be function normally. Like, I can move my hand around, it doesn't look bad, but by the way, this is not creative editing on my part. And now I'm screwed, I think. Yep. it does give you two chances to miss, but if you miss a two and then you know there's another two coming, you're going to miss one, which will kill the game for you. I mean, look at this. I mean, I know this game only cost $1.95, but come on. And as annoying as this is even more playable than Arcade Redemption. I can't wait to finish this so I can clear 30 gigs worth of games I don't need off my hard drive. I mean, I know that this is shovelware, but at least put some effort into this. Okay, I got one more chance. I really don't want to have to do this anymore. Again, when you're playing campaign, you use the stars to unlock new games. This is not a game.
This is just
a test of patience. So how was everybody's Christmas? Did you get everything you wanted? Fortunately, I got some better games than this, but I'll save those for another day. Specifically January 2nd, where I'm doing a my new annual birthday video. I will admit this is challenging, but the challenge should not be trying to figure out this game's dog shit controls. Did it? Oh, please let this one. Yes. 2 stars. Oh yeah, and this is another thing that annoys me about this game. It says I got 2 stars, gives me some creepy sounding applause, then it kicks you back out to the main screen. Now we're only going to be doing the top 4 because this one isn't functional at all, this one's barely functional and I've tried. And what's up with you? Now this is Slam-A-Winner. This one is actually easier to understand. Now, you only have a small amount of quarters as compared to Stacker, but it's actually easier to win. But this is not a skill game. This is a luck game. You just tap it, the ball bounces, and then it lands in a hole, and you get numbers. You get you get whatever prize is on the hole, and whatever if you make it to 200, you get 1 star. 260, you get another star. Now I know what you're thinking. Wouldn't it be easier to just flood the chamber with bouncy balls? Never, ever do that. That's a terrible move. Because every time you drop a ball, if there's one on the playfield, it erases it. So all you're doing is wasting plays. The good thing is, and I didn't even notice this because I'm usually able to hit it in my first couple of plays, but your score actually doesn't go away whenever you put a new coin in. So if we're strategic enough, we can and again, it's not like you lose money or health or anything else because you don't make a goal. Thank you. so we got four chances left to somehow earn 14 points. We have one play. We have three plays left. We have to get 9 points. Or excuse me, 7 points. That... So it gives you 2 stars. Now, I don't remember... Oh, Bulldozer. Now, this is one that I have no patience for. So... this is one of the most idiotic setups that I've ever seen, for the simple fact that rather than lining up the bottom area with 10 points, you have it bonus plays, which really don't do anything because you've wasted a play. And basically your goal is to line the dozer up and push the block out. Seem like against the odds, but believe me, I've played this before, and you'll win with persistence. Like, see there, I wasn't good. There you go. I am now up 60 points. Actually, of the games, this is actually probably my favorite because it's challenging. It is fun, but it's, again, sort of like saying I have syphilis, the best of the sexually transmitted diseases. I'm trying to remember where that quote came from. You don't get bonuses for going over the stated goals, so there's really no point doing so. And there we go. And we come to the last game. The last functional game, I should say. Now, this is the alpha version, but this does work. Okay, could we just take a second to appreciate how creepy that background image is? Holy shit. This is another slow, boring game, but this one you really can't lose. Because you're given a generous amount of coins to begin with, but every time you knock one over, your supply replenishes. Now, you see these two stars, that's your objective. And you can't rapid fire. You know, why would you want to do that? Why would you want to fire in a coin push? Why would you want to do that? What fun could there possibly be? I mean, I'm not saying much right now, because what else is there to say about this? This is not... And look at those coin physics, man. One star. Okay, let's get the other one so I can end this already. This is a game that's so generous with its coin amount, you can't lose. okay, you can rapid fire. I just hadn't figured it out. Okay. I got 2 stars. Can't even have 3. You gotta go 2. So yeah, this is it is what it is. It's not a good game. I don't recommend it. Get the coin game. That's basically what this is. The example of why cheap knockoffs are not always a good thing. So we're gonna go from the virtual world to the real world with the next game I'm gonna play. I'm Dave Firestone, and I'll be right back. So with our third holiday tasting segment on the 2022 Christmas special, we're going to try something a little different that I came across. Now, anyone who knows me knows I'm a ginger ale person. I do like ginger beer, but I've never heard of this before. This is actually a mixer, but it sounded too good not to try. Cue tropical ginger beer. It's a ginger beer with ginger, agave, extracts of passion fruit, and pineapple. Getting kind of a weird amalgamation of the various scents. Very, very, very gingery. Definitive tropical flavor. You're just getting like a little bit of it and then being overwhelmed by the ginger. But that being said, I do like this. Yeah, this is more of a ginger bite than I was expecting. This is weird because it has a good flavor, it has a good ginger bite, but it's not a tropical tasting thing at all. If I said tropical punch, you'd get an immediate flavor, and this, while it's good, doesn't... So... I like this, but it really doesn't deliver what it promises in terms of a tropical flavor to it. With that said, I'll give it an A-. Got one more tasting segment to go, but we'll get to that in a little bit. I'm Dave Firestone. Let's get back to the Christmas special. Slot machine that I won at Dave & Buster's earlier this year. We're going to be doing a 20-play challenge, so let's get started.
This thing has no weight to it, even though it's full of coins, so it's like... This is a 20 play challenge.
So welcome back, everyone. Now the holidays are a time to spend with friends and enjoying different kinds of treats. I've got my friend Josh here, and I've got a treat for him. A couple treats, actually. Now when I saw this in the store, I just bought it because I knew I was going to have to try it. We're doing two beers. The first is from Chicago's Revolution Brewing. It's called Caramel Crisp Caramel Popcorn Ale, and it's made in conjunction with Garrett Popcorn. Before we started this, but oh well. Give it a scent. Now let's see. This is, I'm trying to figure out what specific kind of beer this is. Good caramel flavor to
it. A little soda, clean as beers go.
Not bad.
I'd say pretty good. This could be like a regular drinking.
Yeah.
If I drank beer, I would have made it easy.
Yeah, so... I'm going to insist that we finish it because we do have another beer to get to.
Finish it.
Beer to.
you too, and let's be honest here, you're not the most attractive person in the world. I'm sorry you'll always be inferior in your respect. We kid because we love.
Exactly. And that's strictly platonic sense.
Yeah.
On each other. We've been friends since high school.
25 years. Yeah, my how time flies. Actually, the one that we tried, the Garrett Popcorn Beer, was actually the less weird flavor we're going to be trying today. Because, again, I saw this, and I just had to buy it just on site. Now we're going to Lake Zurich to Three Phase Brewing. For their A Bushel of Apples. A Bushel of Apples, which is made in conjunction with Affy Tap. Split one can?
Yeah.
Alright, I can do that. Caramel apple. Don't want a lot of foam like this. There's less than an inch of foam, so it's good. Mm-hmm. Ooh, really caramel apple scent to it. Oof. 6% alcohol by volume.
Strong flavor.
Yeah, a little too strong for my.
Yeah.
I don't mind a beer with a flavor in it, but when the flavor's overpowering, I mean, it's a good flavor, do not misunderstand me, but it also has a really weird aftertaste.
Yeah, there's now, a bit of a medicine aftertaste almost, like yeah, I just took some NyQuil or something. It is pretty good. But it's the type of beer I'd have to get used to before I drink it on a regular basis.
I think it could be a little sweeter since it is a caramel apple flavor. I mean, salted caramel is one thing, but caramel apples are completely different. And you want it a little sweeter.
Yeah.
Not that I'm a big fan of Affy Tapple, only because I don't like factory-made caramel apples. Mm-hmm. Like, I like the kind of caramel apples I like. You go to the fair, and it's a giant apple, and it's coated in caramel, and covered in, like, sprinkles and candy. Mm-hmm. Like, if you're gonna go for a caramel apple, you go all out.
Okay.
But this isn't bad. I mean, I've certainly had worse on this channel. Needs to be sweeter, the aftertaste could be toned down, and the taste taste is a little too powerful for my, for our liking, but it's certainly not bad by any means. It's just, it needs a few tweaks.
Yeah, I would have to agree. My overall grade would be a B, and pretty much I'd have to agree with what mostly he said. Yeah, maybe a little sweeter, maybe a little milder flavor, but it's still pretty nice. It's still better than a lot of the mainstream stuff we have out today.
Yep.
Certainly more interesting, you can definitely say that much.
Yes. Alright, so that about does it for this particular segment. We'll be getting to the next segment momentarily. From Josh and I, Merry Christmas. Our last short for this year's Christmas special was produced by the Edison Manufacturing Company and was released in 1914 by the General Film Company. The Adventures of the Wrong Santa Claus tells the story of a burglar in a Santa suit who steals a family's presents, and Octavius, the amateur detective who tries to track him down. There's really not much else to say about it, so let's get to it. So with the final gameplay video of the 2022 Christmas special, we're going to be doing this play and win game that I picked up on a whim one day. Now the goal is you put a coin in, you flip this, you try to get it in the hole. So I don't have any quarters handy. We're going to be doing various kinds of spare change. And we're just going to see how much I can score. Started for I'm playing this Stone Cold Sober. This is a bar game. Could you imagine trying to play this drunk? Alright, that didn't work. Most bars, I think, can adapt their own. Did I hit anything? No. Looked like it did. I know it says you're supposed to use quarters, but this is my game and I'll do whatever the hell I want. Thank you. my god, did I get it? I'll check at the end. Two pennies. Well,
we're gonna move on to the outro next, so let's get to that.
And with that, the 2022 DGF 2099 Productions Christmas special comes to an end. I want to thank all my subscribers and my fans for their support over the years. Again, I hope you've all had a great 2022. I wish you all a great 2023. I'm not going anywhere. I'm going to be doing my thing. I hope you're with me for it. And thank you all again. Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, Happy New Year. I'll see you next year.